Get ready to match the stars. Orson Dean. Brett Summers. Gary Burghoff. Lynda Day Jones. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Body Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75.
Just walking by, I thought I'd stop in and say hello.
How are you?
Hello.
Good to see you again.
How are you?
Terrific.
You all right? You okay?
Terrific. Ma got me drunk during lunch.
What was that?
Ma got me drunk during lunch.
No.
That's true. He spiked my Coke. She doesn't know I'm talking about her. She thinks I mean Orson.
I was watching, peeking through my little peek hole backstage here. What were you two guys?
I peeked over and saw what he'd drawn, the glasses with the stars on. So I quickly drew the same thing and then showed it to him. And said, sure, I would just really just over you.
I didn't really show it to him,
but just pretended to.
He'll do it to you every time. Are you ready down in the lower tier?
I am.
Okay. Shall we say hello to our players here, Joy Anderson and Peter Tripp?
Hello there, players.
Joy is our current champion. She's won $2,850, and she's happy about that. I haven't asked you what you're going to do with that money, have I?
I'm going to become an earthworm farmer.
An earthworm farmer.
That's a very...
You're going to become an earthwoman what?
An earthworm farmer.
Oh, I thought she said...
Now, wait a minute. It just so happens that one of our celebrities is an earthworm farmer.
You're kidding.
Would you guess? Look up the weirdos. Which one would you say is the earthworm farmer over there?
Betty.
Who? Betty?
Betty has worms, but she's...
No, this is not part of the program. You're not going to get anything if you guess right.
It's a very common illness in the White House. Tapeworms.
No. Gary has a couple of big boxes where he raises worms, and he feeds... He's got a protein farm. He raises trouts, and he feeds them worms. He's an earthworm farmer. I don't know how I got trapped into all this.
It's a wonderful business.
I manufacture Toll House cookies for his worms.
So, you've got $2,850. We started this game last time we were together. Finished your question, right? And your first round question is going to come along. Are you ready for that, Peter?
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready for yours?
Yes, I am.
All right, we'll continue right after this. Now we're ready to carry on. I put my finger on that button and nothing happens. And there it happens. And this is your question, Joy Anderson. Listen carefully.
Yes, what is
Brett.
It?
Brett.
Brett.
Uh-oh. Be very careful.
Oh, brother.
Brett.
I carry a gun.
Shh.
On several diseases.
Brett said to the makeup man, make me beautiful. And the man said, listen, lady, I'm a makeup man, not a blank. I love you, too. Nothing personal, but write something rotten about Brett.
Brett says, I carry a gun, and Gary mumbles on several diseases.
All right. Orson finished. Brett finished.
You may find this hard to believe, but somebody rushed up to me during the dinner hour and said, may I have your autograph, Miss George?
No.
And I said, Mrs. George.
Mrs. George.
Gladys George was never married.
What they said was, hey, George, can I with
hey,
a sign,
George,
this
yes,
is what
of course.
They said.
Now we come to Joy Anderson. Brett said to the makeup man, make me beautiful, darling. Now the man said, listen, lady, I'm a makeup man, not a blank.
A plastic surgeon.
Not a plastic surgeon. He's in a plastic surgeon.
Cut that out.
Stop that applauding there. Her face ain't hanging down that much. Thank you. Orson?
It's not her face.
Go.
I went a little further than that. I said, I'm a makeup man, not a miracle worker.
That wasn't very hostile now. Just be prepared for some...
I think you're quite lovely.
See?
But what do I know?
No.
Stop this kissing. It's,
I don't know what's wrong with that awful woman in the red skirt and jacket and scarf and all that stuff. I always thought she was nice up until now.
Yes, what did you
but
say?
But I said plastic surgeon.
Plastic surgeon, too. That's one for you, Joy Anderson.
You see...
And the man said, listen, lady, I'm a makeup man, not a blank.
You see, there's a point at which you are even beyond the aid of a plastic surgeon. I said a morticianer.
That doesn't even make sense.
No,
it certainly does. They make people beautiful.
Yes, that's
when
right.
When they're over the hill.
Let's not. Boy, I'll
over
say.
The
I may be over the hill, but I ain't dating.
No, not
am
exactly.
I?
No, you're not. No, you're a lively one. Now we come to you, Lynda Day, George. What do you say? Listen, lady, I'm a makeup man, not a plastic surgeon, according to Joy Anderson. What say you?
Well, I said the miracle man. I really wanted...
A miracle man.
And I didn't mean it, Brett.
No.
It's all right, you little ugly duckling.
All right, Richard, we're up to you.
This, you have to listen very carefully to my answer.
Listen carefully to his answer.
I knew the makeup man quite well.
Yes.
The delightful gentleman had a small lisp.
Yes.
And he said...
Listen, lady, I'm a makeup man, not a...
A faith healer.
A faith healer.
Intellectual.
Yes, very intellectual
very
answer.
Beautiful.
Boy, it taxed my intellect. What about your intellect?
Well, I...
You don't
everybody
have none.
Expected... Now, I was kind to you. Everybody expected me to say something nasty, and I think it's pretty obvious that Brett and I really love each other under all this, so I said he's not a magician.
Magician. Abracadabra! So at the end of round one, 1-0, favor of our current champion, Joy Anderson. Round two will happen in about a minute or so you come back. Now we go to round two. Ready? Go. All right, Peter Tripp.
I'll try A this time.
A, it is. Everybody plays because Peter didn't match anybody in his first round question. Dumb Dora thought her waterbed was too soft, so she put blank in the water. She was so dumb, she put blank in the water. That's how dumb she was. Thought her waterbed was too soft, so she put blank in the water.
Got it.
Oh!
May I change my mind?
You may change your mind.
Honey,
it's a woman's privilege.
This answer.
No, I can't change my mind.
You can if you want to. I mean, does everybody understand this?
Not unless it makes sense.
I understand it perfectly.
The first time I read it, I misunderstood it. Dumb Dora thought her waterbed was too soft, so she put blank in the water.
Get it, Dickie?
Does everybody understand it?
I think we're overemphasizing the question.
But you're not going to answer it.
Well, I've got no answer for it.
Okay.
I love my answer.
You love your answer?
Yes. Oh. First time this week, I've really been crazy about my... Oh, wait a minute. My false eyelashes are coming out.
You know, for the last couple days, she's been wearing her own hair. And if you'll notice, she's making it a little gray. Betty White, why do you fiddle around like that when I walk out there? You really are. Can't stand near to that girl. I mean, she's been married to what's-his-name so long, you know, she just can't keep her hands off me. All right, everybody ready over there? Now, we come to you, Peter Tripp. Dumb Dora thought her waterbed was too soft, so she put blank in the water.
Cement?
Cement. Yay! You like cement. Okay.
Oh, no.
Now, I'll stand here, and you can fix my trouser leg while I'm talking to Orson. Dumb Dora thought her waterbed was too soft, she put cement in the water, according to Peter Tripp.
While you're talking to Dumb Orson, starch in the water.
Starch! In the water. Starch.
No. I got the answer.
What?
You kids are going to go crazy.
Tell us.
Now, keep in mind, the operative words are Dumb Dora.
Right.
Now, be prepared.
Right.
Dumb Dora was so dumb, she put ice in her waterbed. answer, isn't it?
Because ice indeed is hard water.
Hard, and then it will melt. She's, do you
That's
get it,
right.
Honey?
She's so dumb, she doesn't
Richard,
realize
do
it'll melt.
You get it, honey?
He doesn't want
I'm
it.
I'm sorry, Richard's not here at the moment.
He must have gotten it. He's scratching all over the place.
That's a
what do you say?
Answer.
She put blank in the water.
Blank what?
I mean,
cement?
Cement! Yes, atta boy. Splendid. All right. You didn't help me out in my hour of need, did you?
Yes.
Well, we did.
May we see your answer?
Yes. I didn't spell it right. Concrete.
Concrete. That's a match. Spelling doesn't count here. It's perfectly okay.
Okay.
Richard?
Yeah.
She was thought her waterbed was too soft, so she put cement in the water, according to Peter.
I thought you said that material was pre-shrunk.
Yes, it is.
I'm going to wear knickers on this show from now. Cement.
There's another one for you, Peter. Splendid. Would you give him a little cement?
I would, but you know you've heard me say time and time again, if I ever agree with Brett, it'll be a cold day. Well, ice.
Ice. It was a cold day. Okay, so Peter, you scored 3 with that one. Now, Joy, you need 2 to match, 3 to win. Ready? Everyone plays except Brett.
Yes.
How did that happen? How did you outsmart the others there?
I'm not at liberty to say.
Here we go. Miss Kitty from Gunsmoke said, last night in my saloon, Marshall Dillon got so drunk, he got his blank caught in the spittoon. That's how drunk Marshall Dillon got.
That's pretty drunk.
He got his blank caught in the spittoon. All right. We had a girl here one day who was playing, and she didn't know what a spittoon was. It came up in another context, and you know what a spittoon is, don't you? I mean,
I sure do.
It's a circular brass device. It's partially full.
Gee, I thought it was something you spit in.
Just, can I borrow a piece of your chaw, ma'am? Everybody right over there. Okay, here we go with Joy Anderson. Miss Kitty from Gunsmoke said, last night in my saloon, Marshall Dillon got so drunk, he got his blank caught in the spittoon.
His gun.
He got his gun caught. The audience is very nervous for you, she said. Got his gun caught in the spittoon.
Well, I've done my best.
Yes. Orson, you're
not
up.
Not lately.
This is like the crowd of villagers in the Frankenstein pictures. Half you go this way, half you go that way. Flaming faggots searching for the monster.
Stop it!
All right. I'm afraid he got his spurs caught.
Got his spurs caught in the spittoon. Yeah, you see, he got those big spurs, the jingle jangle. Now, Gary, you're up.
And I said, his boot and or foot.
Boot and or foot.
When you
so
have
far.
A dumb answer, make a funny voice.
No gun in the spittoon. Have you got a gun in the spittoon for this little lady over here?
If you got a dumb answer, use a funny voice.
Foot, boot, or shoe. No, now wait a minute. Foot, boot, or shoe is really not a dumb answer. That's a logical answer. Because if a guy is drunk and he's reeling around like that, he could easily get his foot caught in a spittoon now, couldn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, but
there?
Logic is dumb on this show.
Oh, that's
I found
right.
That out.
Heaven forfend he should fall down.
What do you say?
Well. Give you a clue?
Yes.
I said foot, my dog.
Foot.
Okay, so that means Peter Griffin's game. What'd you have? Foot. Hello, come in,
congratulations. Please stand by for a moment. Joy, I hope you had a good time here.
Yes, but if I don't mention my 3 grandkids.
You have to mention your 3
I
grandkids?
Christy and D. Goad and Jennifer Anderson.
Okay. We wish them well, as we do you too. You got $2,850. Thank you, Joy Anderson. Goodbye. Dallas is spinning off a spinless message for you. Come right back. Peter Tripp is up here for the first time, and he's got his $100. He's going to try for over $5,000 now. How do you feel about that, Peter?
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not kidding.
It's far out. I think it's pretty fantastic.
Good. All right, Peter, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank George. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, and the third, $100. Whom do you call on here for a little help?
My wife said she'd kill me if I didn't pick Richard Dawson.
All right.
Name I used to wrestle home under, Gorgeous George.
Gorgeous George. All right, there's one.
Gary Burghoff.
Gary.
Out of deference to the first role, Lynda Day George.
Lynda Day George.
It's the same as Gorgeous George.
Is that okay. How you spell it?
And Orson Bean.
Oh!
I have a blank George.
Yeah, there's...
Doesn't have a winner.
I don't have a winner here. Sister George, Gladys George, and Susan George. I guess... How old a crowd was that?
Well, it was a regular bunch like this, yeah. Over the hill. A minute ago, you were my friend. No, they see, that's a cross-section of America, you know, all kinds of nice people. So give us one, Orson.
That was my brother, George. I guess... Gladys George? That's too ridiculously old, right?
Gladys George? Well, that's...
Susan George. No, that's...
Gladys George is the answer we have to go with, because that's what he said first, and that's it. So you've got Gladys George... Lynda Day George and Gorgeous George. Do you want one of those, or have you got one in your head?
Well, I had one in my head, but I'm going to go with Rich Dawson. With Rich. Gorgeous George.
With Gorgeous George. Okay. Just out of curiosity, what was the one you had in your head? Gorgeous George is the one we're going to go for, but let me know what...
George. By George.
By George, you think?
St. George, too.
And what?
And St. George.
St. George,
yeah, I just
too.
Remembered him.
That's right. And King George. Yeah. Oh, there are all kinds of good ones. And you're going with Gorgeous George, huh? A wrestler we've forgotten 30 years ago. That's, you think, that they... All right.
He'll just never be forgotten.
No. All right. Let's find out where Gorgeous George is. Gorgeous George, are you under the $100 response? Lynda Day George.
Well, for heaven's sake.
Lynda George,
okay, Gorgeous George, are you worth $250? Gorgeous George! Congratulations! So, now you got $350.
Yeah.
You think By George is up there?
Yeah.
All right, Earl, slide it along there. By George as well. You say by... No, you said By George, and you rejected it. That's 40 lashes.
I'm so dumb.
Well, listen now. You've got $250 more. You're going to play for $2,500. Which one celebrity do you want to try to match?
Brett Summers.
Brett.
Oh, my Lord!
I don't get the vapors.
I already have them.
All right, you face me if you would, Peter. Here it is, worth $2,500. Now, don't be nervous.
I'm not. I'm fainting.
I know you haven't done this in a long time, but here's the way
it's
goes.
It's such a burden.
Blank ocean. Blank ocean. Okay, she's finished. Now, Peter, we need an answer from you which you think will match hers. What's your judgment on this? Blank ocean.
Pacific Ocean.
Pacific. Okay. She says, he says, for $2,500, that Pacific Ocean will match you, Brett. It's show and tell time, please.
I don't know what to say because, you know, I was brought up in Maine.
In Maine, which is where the Atlantic Ocean is, yes.
But I've lived here for a long time.
Mr. Wright.
It's Mr. $2,850. Good for you, Peter. We'll get right back to Peter Tripp, but first we're going to do a little business with America, and this is it.
That's great. A lady in the audience just said, I'm glad you showed your knee, because I have a knee that looks exactly like yours. I have beautiful knees. I'll show you mine if you'll show me yours. I mean, I've already showed you mine. I want to see your knee. Just, yes. No, okay.
You'll put your knees against hers anytime,
that's
won't
right.
You?
Did I tell you how to get rid of water on the knee?
How do you get rid of water on the knee?
Wear pumps. Say goodnight.
T-Raven, match game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.